Hey guys, Ravi here, and this is the LoRa module, specifically the RYLR896 from REYAX, who were kind enough to sponsor this video, so a big thanks to them. Anyways, LoRa stands for long range, and I mean long, as in up to and even more than 10 kilometers of range. This is with line of sight, of course. This insane range at low power requirements is not without issue though. You are sacrificing speed as well as bandwidth by a lot. So don't expect LoRa to replace your Wi-Fi anytime soon. But that doesn't mean that you can't use it for most of the IoT applications you can think of. And that is exactly what I am going to show you guys in this video. How you can use LoRa in your IoT projects. Before we get started though, I want to make one distinction clear to you guys. And that is between LoRa and LoRaWAN. LoRaWAN is a protocol developed by the LoRa Alliance, which anybody can use to connect their LoRa-enabled devices to the internet, similar to how your Wi-Fi-enabled devices connect to your Wi-Fi router to access the internet. But unlike Wi-Fi, LoRaWAN uses LoRa gateways, works at way longer distances, and for small bandwidth data. If you wanna know more about what LoRaWAN is, then I suggest you take a look at this video by Andreas. He does a really good job of explaining it all. What I'll be showing you here is more like Bluetooth. We'll connect two LoRa modules together in a point-to-point network to share data between them too. I'll show you how you can build a simple wireless switch that works at ridiculously long distances, and you can expand upon that as you wish. Now, this particular LoRa module from REYAX uses UART for communication with your microcontroller. That is the same protocol that you use to print to the serial monitor in Arduino. It's pretty simple. You just use serial.print and send whatever you wanna send. What you do wanna send to control this particular module are AT commands. AT commands, if you aren't familiar with them, are even simpler. AT stands for attention. Like a drill sergeant, you shout attention, followed by whatever orders you wanna send. Just to demonstrate, I'll connect one module to my PC using a USB to TTL converter. Just connect VCC to 3.3 volt, ground to ground, RX to TX and TX to RX. Opening a serial monitor at the baud rate of 115200, you can send to it 80, and like a good little private, it will respond with an OK. If you wanna send a command, you say 80 plus whatever command you wanna send. Like we can set this module's address to 115. Press enter and it should return OK for successful execution. Now we just need to implement this in an Arduino sketch. I have already written the sketches, one for the transmitter and one for the receiver, both of which you can download from the link in the description. I am not gonna go through the code here because it's boring and no one wants to sit through that. But I do want to point out a few key things that you might want to take note of for when you write your own code. Number 1. Each AT command needs to end with a /r/n. This is equivalent to pressing enter on your keyboard. Without this, the module won't know when the command has ended. Second, each module needs to be set up before use. This is what this part of the code does. You need to set the parameter, the bandwidth, the network ID and the address. While the first three need to be the same for both the transmitter and the receiver, the address needs to be unique for each. Number 3. To send data, the syntax is AT plus send equals the address you want to send to, comma, the length of data you want to send in bytes, comma, the data you want to send. Here we are just sending 0 and 1 depending on what button is pressed. Whenever data is received, it is printed directly to the serial, the syntax of which is this. So you need to look for the string starting with plus RCV. The part that we are interested in is in between the second and third comma. Finally, make sure to initialize the serial at 115200 baud rate, which is the default. You can change it with an AT command if you so wish. After uploading the code to both the Arduinos, the wiring couldn't be simpler. Connect VCC to 3.3 volt, RX to TX, TX to RX and ground to ground. On the board with the transmitter code, connect two push buttons to pin 5 and 6. The other end of those push buttons goes to ground. On the receiver, connect a LED between pin 5 and ground with a resistor. Power them both on, give them a few seconds to complete the setup, and now when you press the buttons, the LED should switch states. But the cool thing is that it works at really large distances. Before I leave you to play with this though, I should mention that different frequencies are permitted in different countries. So you should buy only the device that is compatible with your location and set the frequency accordingly. This particular module allows for 868 or 915 MHz, which incidentally are allowed in most of the world. Hopefully this video was helpful. Leave a like if it was. Thanks again to REYAX for sponsoring this video. Link to buy their LoRa module will be in the description down below. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you guys in the next one.